Hello, Michael here. I got a question from Brian Schumacher. He's using a layer emitter in Trapcode Particular, and he's saying he has to crank his particle count up to like 50,000 per second just to even see some particles. Well, here's why. When you take some text, precomp it, you've got a bunch of invisible particles being emitted because Trapcode Particular emits from the whole layer size, regardless of alpha. So you got a bajillion invisible particles from the top and the bottom and the sides of your text that are just emitting all the time, and you can't see them. You don't want to do that. You want to make your layer emitter as small as you possibly can because it'll make everything more efficient. So you might think, oh, Michael, I know. I'll just make my precomp that contains my text the size of my text layer. And that would certainly help. But in this case, we're doing a text-to-snow transition. Also works for text-to-sand transitions. And we're really only emitting particles from a little strip along the whole text. So how do we make that happen? Well, here's what I do. As you can see, just nothing very complicated, just some particles poofing away. And it's a lovely little text to snow transition. But how do I make it so my particle count only at 3,000? And you can see lots and lots of particles. That's because the layer that I'm emitting from is only this big. So if I solo it here, you can see that as it moves left to right, it seems to be revealing the text inside of itself. Wah! How does that work? Well, it's actually very, very simple. In my text to be snowed, I've got the precomp of the text tucked inside here. And it's a very tiny comp. And you can see there's a little expression here in the position. And it says, hey, take whatever the value is. The main comp is 960 that this text is inside of. So I'm saying, hey, I don't want to worry about that 960. But we're going to minus the position on X. So anytime this is animated in here in the main comp, this precomp is animating in the opposite direction. So when the layer moves from this side of the text all the way to that side, everything inside here is scooching along. And the result is that you just get this little tiny strip of text. So all I have is this layer disappearing. I'm wiping it off with this little rough and edges text wipe here, track matting that, and particular. So that's how I do it. It gets you the lowest particle count and still gets you that lovely text to sand transition. Bye.